Yo, what's up YouTube? It's your boy J-Hawk here and welcome to the Western Conference first round video. Same thing like yesterday, you already know. We lost the Clips to games 1 through 3. So we're going to get into the Western Conference today. If you guys missed the Eastern Conference video, go ahead and pause it real quick and run that back real quick. Go ahead and get caught up on what happened out East as we get ready to catch up out West, and then we'll be ready to get into the second round. It should be fun. So yeah, I'm gonna quit talking and roll the intro.
Yeah, I run away in fear of me dying today, and I'm not the same. Who said I was subject to change? My demons are breaking out of
All right, guys, so when I got that Eastern Conference video posted, I had noticed that I forgot to put any instrumental music on it. So the same thing's going to apply to this video, too, no instrumental. But going forward, we will get back to the instrumental. It's just I had a blunder. That was on me. But let's go ahead and get into reviewing some of this basketball, and we're starting out with the 3-6 matchup, the LA Palms taking on the St. Louis Rivermen. So it pops up right now. Boom. But game one ended in an 82-79 victory for the Palms. Now in this game, Tatum got an and one with like 3 seconds to go. And St. Louis threw one up from half court just to see if they would tie it, and they almost went in. So, that's how LA won game one. Tatum's 29 leading the way. Dragic had 14 and 10. Denny, 14. Wiggins had 8. He struggled from the floor. Powell had 6 points. Didn't even make a single field goal. He hit 6 free throws, so not bad for him. For St. Louis right here, Zion, 22 points, 11 rebounds in his playoff debut. Bagley had 12 points, 9 rebounds. He shot 3 of 11. Very struggling performance for him, but he shot 6 of 7 from the free throw line to help out. LaMelo had 9 and 7. Cole Anthony with 9 points. Kevon Looney, 9 points. Fournier had 8 points. Like, St. Louis played really good as a team. They just couldn't get enough done in game 1 to get the victory. So that brings us to game 2 now, still in L.A. And this time St. Louis with an 89-79 victory against the Palms. Tatum leading the way with 15 points for the Palms, but he shot 5 of 13, kind of struggled in this one. Montrezl Harrell had 11 points. Most of his points came from the free throw line. Powell had 10 points. Wiggins 10 points, but he shot 3 of 11. Struggled right there. Denny had 10 points also. Dragic dropped down to 9 points, didn't have any assists either. Thaddeus Young, Austin Rivers had 5 points also. I mean, everybody that played scored for L.A. They just couldn't keep up with what was happening with St. Louis, with Fournier leading the way with 20 points. LaMelo had 15, 7, and 6. Okiki off the bench with 11 points. Zion had 11. He kind of struggled a little bit. Bagley had 10 points. Cole Anthony, 8 points. Like, if everybody's scoring this many points, like in double figures, then you saw the result right there. That brings us to game 3, first playoff game in St. Louis, and they hold down home court for a 77-72 victory. Zion leading the way, 21-7 for him. Fournier had 14 points. Bagley, 13. LaMelo, 12. Okiki with 11. Like, that's what dominated them, with having 5 players in double digits. Cole Anthony had 4 points, and Dylan Windler, there we go. He had the other 2 points. That's crazy. For L.A., Norman Powell led the way with 14. Tatum struggled again. 5 of 13 shooting, he had 12 points. Denny had 11. He struggled, 4 of 11. Montrez had 10 on 4 of 9 shooting. Dragic, 3 of 9, 9 points. Like, if they struggle from the floor, if they shoot better, then they probably win this game. But, yeah, that's what we got in this series so far. St. Louis up 2-1, the 6th seed. Let's see if they can make some magic and move on to round 2, or if LA can show that they're the higher seed and win this series. So let's check out the highlights for the rest of the series. St. Louis dominates game four at home to take a 3-1 series lead, the sixth seed up on the one or mile. Wow, my English is really bad this video. The sixth seed up on the three seed, 3-1 now. Evan Fournier, 28 points leading the way for St. Louis. LaMelo had 17, Zion with 15. Everybody did their little part to get this win for St. Louis. Jason Tatum leading the way with 22 for LA, but not getting much help that much. Dragic, Wiggins, and Harrell each with 11. Austin Rivers had 7 points in 9 minutes, but the shooting numbers really weren't well for LA, and now they have to climb back out of a 3-1 hole. So let's see what happens as the series heads back to LA for Game 5. Well, how about this? We have our first upset in the playoffs. The 6th-seeded St. Louis Rivermen complete the task and win Game 5, 89-76 on the road in LA to send the 3-seeded Palms out of the playoffs. And we have our third team moving on in the playoffs. The Palms were led by Jason Tatum, 15 points. He got in foul trouble and didn't really have that much support going on. Powell had 12 points. Dragic had 11. Montrez and Denny each had 10, but Denny shot 4 at 12, so he really struggled. For the Rivermen, LaMelo leading the way, 19-9. Zion had 18. Bagley had 18. Fournier had 12. This young group is going to be scary for years to come. I already see it. I see it already. This is going to be a scary little team within the next couple years because all their pieces are, like, so young. LaMelo, Zion, Bagley. You got Thibault, Cole Anthony. Like, this team is very young. So be on the lookout for St. Louis. But they will become the third team to advance to round two here in this episode. Might have more to come. Who knows? But yeah, congrats St. Louis for moving on, and congrats to the Palms for a really good season. Got the 3-seed, just didn't work out well for you guys, but there's always next year. So offseason starts now for LA. St. Louis gets ready to prep for round two.
All right, guys, now we're going to go ahead and get into this matchup, the 4-5 matchup, the Las Vegas Dealers and the OKC Barons. OKC was a 1-seed at one point. They just finished the year kind of rough, and Las Vegas defends home court, 79-55 victory in game one. Kyrie leading the way with 20 points. Jay Crowder had 15. Drew Holiday struggled from the floor, 5 of 16, but he had 11 points. Clint Capella, 8-13 for him. Bridges, 6 points. Jeremy Grant had 6 points. I mean, they dominated this game from start to finish. As you see that first quarter, the first half, they scored 50. They scored 50. It was 50-30 at halftime. Impressive win. For OKC, they were led in scoring by Aaron Gordon's 11 points. He had 4 of 10 shooting. Nurkic had 11-11. He was one of the bright spots. Bradley Beal, 10 points on 5 of 18 shooting. He struggled. If he's going to struggle in OKC, he's in for a long series. Gerald Green, in 8 minutes to play, had 9 points. Marquese Chriss, 8-12 for him. But besides that, like, yeah, my boy Lonzo, 0 of 6. No points scored. He had 5 assists, but big time struggle in game one for them. Game two didn't get even better as Vegas wins 87-66. Drew Holiday this time leading the way with 25 points on 9 of 13 shooting, 6 of 10 from the 3-point line. Kyrie had 23-6, missed only 3 shots, so he played good, and he fouled out. He fouled out, and Capella fouled out too, and he had 10-13. Then Cali signed 9-7. Ben McLemore in 8 minutes had 7 points. Jeremy Grant 6 points. Mikal Bridges 5 points. Like, yeah, they're in trouble. OKC was led by Nurkic 21 points. He played really good. Marquese Chriss had 14-8. Lonzo had a bounce back game, 12 points on 5 of 6 shooting. Bradley Beal struggles again, 8 points, 3 of 9 shooting for him. And it was rough. It was just a rough win. OKC's down 2-0, playing their first home game. And they made it closer, but they still lose by 8 points, 78-86. Nurkic leading the way, 14 points. If Nurkic is going to lead you in scoring, you're not going to win this series. You're now down 3-0. You have to win 4 straight games. Is it possible? Yeah, probably. But not probably going to happen. Probably not going to happen. There's not a good percent
chance that that's going to happen. Nurkic, 14 points, yeah. Bradley Beal shot a little better. Not really. He had 13 points on 5 of 15 shooting. 1 of 8 from the 3-point line. Really struggled. Marquis Chris had 12 and 6. Gerald Green, 11 points in 7 minutes. Yeah, it was rough for them. Come over here. Kyrie dropped 29, 7 assists. He balled out. Drew Holiday, 12 points. Jay Crowder, 12 points. Capella had 10 and 17. Like, come on, man. Like, bro, this series might be a wrap. Las Vegas needing one win to finish up a sweep. We'll see if OKC can make this a series if all. So, let's get into the rest of the highlights. Well, here's the first team in history, in our league history, to get swept out the playoffs. OKC, I don't know what just happened to you guys, but you guys are going home, man. Tough way to end your season. Used to be early in the year, we're contending for that number one seed, but now you're going home. 4-0 sweep by Las Vegas, winning the final game by a score of 87-63. So Vegas will become the first team to advance. They will play the winner of the 1-8 matchup of Dallas and Portland. Yeah. Okay, so you're going to have to pack it up and try again next year. Bradley Beal, 16 points leading the way. Marquise Chris had 13. Nurkic with 11. Yeah, but that's going to end their season. Kyrie dropped 40 in a closeout. Oh, my God, Kyrie. He had 40. Drew Holiday had 21. They combined for 61. They almost outscored OKC by themselves. Mikal Bridges had 10 points. Yeah. Kyrie dropped 40 to close out OKC on the road. So OKC is going home. Vegas moving on to round two. So congrats to the Dealers on being the first team to advance to round two.
All right. Now it's time to get into the matchup, the 2-7 matchup. And the Eastern Conference one was pretty good. Game one right here, Arizona and Vancouver. I'm so upset that I lost the Clips for this. 70-69 victory for Arizona on a game-winning three at the buzzer by Gordon Hayward on an inbounds pass. Open in the corner, green light. It, like, so hurt that I lost the clip. He only had 5 points. He only hit 1-3, and it was the game-winner. DeRozan leading the way with 22 points. Okay, I know this is not custom league. DeRozan, I will accept you on the Lakers. You, Kyle Lowry, Dinwiddie, come on. I'll take all three of you guys. Someone's going to have to come off the bench, but come on. DeRozan with 22 points. DiVincenzo had 12 points. He struggled from the floor. Both of them didn't really shoot the ball well. Steven Adams had 9 and 11. Both teams really didn't shoot the ball that well, to be honest. Looking at Vancouver, Ben Simmons led the way at 18 points. Michael Porter Jr. had 13. He struggled from the floor. I mean, it was a struggle. RJ Barrett had 7 points on 2 of 8 shooting. He kind of struggled. It was just a defensive game for game one in this series. Game two goes Vancouver's way, 75-70. DeRozan leading the way again, 25 points. He missed one total shot. Missed one shot. Cameron Payne had 13. He had 13 points. He only shot 3 times. He shot 10 of 12 from the free throw line. I kid you not. Kid you not. Patty Mills, 11 points. He struggled from the floor, 4 of 10. 3 of 9 from the 3-point line. Tough game. Tough game. Michael Porter Jr. leading the way, 20 points for the Yetis. Okongwu with 14. Ben Simmons had 8 points, 12 assists. Big game right there. RJ, 7 points. Like, this Vancouver team is young. It kind of reminds me of, what team am I thinking? St. Louis. St. Louis is young because they got all these key pieces like Zion, Marvin Bagley, Cole Anthony, LaMelo. Like, that team is so young. Reminds me of Vancouver. So, honestly, in a couple years, if Vancouver and St. Louis are dominating the league, don't be surprised. So game three, we go to Vancouver, and Arizona gets a 7-point road win, 74-67. For Vancouver, it was Ben Simmons and Michael Porter Jr., both with 17 points. They did their thing. RJ still struggling to shoot, but he had 8 points. Not bad. We're looking at Arizona now, and DeRozan led the way with 19 points. DiVincenzo had 13. Okoji and Cameron Payne each with 10 points. 4 players in double figures. That's usually going to help you win a ball game. So Arizona's got a 2-1 lead. Let's see what happens in the rest of these highlights. Let's see if Vancouver, as a 7 seed, can force 7 games. I would love to see that, but we'll see what happens.
Vancouver dominates game 4 of this series to even it up at 2 apiece. 72-49 victory. It took Arizona a while, actually, to score in the fourth quarter. That was rough. They were getting outscored, like, I think 15-0 at one point in the fourth quarter. But Vancouver with the win. Simmons leading the way. Ben Simmons, 18 points. Michael Porter Jr. also had 18. Okongwu had 10 points. Not really that many high scorers on this team. DeRozan led the way with 12 points for Arizona, and then it was it. Cameron Payne, 8 points off the bench. Gordon Hayward didn't do bad. He got in foul trouble, though. Enes Kanter, 7 points. I mean, Arizona just offensively couldn't get nothing going. Patty Mills shot the ball bad. But, yeah, Vancouver tying the series at 2 apiece as we head back to Arizona for Game 5. Alright guys, we're going to hop in here. Game 5 in Arizona. Vancouver down 6 points. I mean, the series is tied 2 apiece, so whoever wins this game will have a 3-2 series lead. Let's see if Arizona can hold on to a 6-point lead or if Vancouver can mount a comeback. Arizona holds on and gets a 6-point win at home to take a 3-2 series lead as the series will shift back to Canada on the next game. I almost said a day of the week. Wow. Gordon Hayward leading the way, 18 points for the Blaze. DeRozan had 17, Patty Mills and Enes Kanter both had 14 points. A lot of scoring. A lot of good shooting for Arizona gets them this win. For Vancouver, Ben Simmons, Michael Porter Jr. each have 23. RJ and Hernan Gomez each with 10 points. Okongwu had 8 points. I mean, a lot of good shooting on both sides. Just Arizona had enough to win this game. So Arizona up 3-2. And like I said, the series heads to Canada, Vancouver, trying to win at home to force a game 7. So let's see what happens. All right, here we go. Game 6. Vancouver needing the win to keep the series alive. Arizona with a win will move on to round 2 and take on St. Louis. But we got ourselves a tie game less than 5 minutes ago, so we're going to hop in and see the end of this one. Well, Vancouver becomes the fourth team to force a game 7 with their 80-72 victory. Hernan Gomez leading the way with 16 for the Yetis. Michael Porter had 11. Ben Simmons and Chandler Hutchinson had 10 points. Okongwu had 9 and 7. Derek White with 9. I mean, big time team win by Vancouver. DeRozan leading the way for Arizona with 20 points. Steven Adams 15 points. Gordon Hayward had 9. I mean, they just didn't make enough shots to win this game. So next episode's getting better now. 4 game 7s. Are we going to have a 5th one? We'll see. We'll see. It just depends on what happens with the Dallas-Portland series. But yeah. So Arizona and Vancouver add to the list of game 7s. Alright guys. Final game 7. Let's hop in and see what happens. 3-point game.
Man, my heart hurts for Vancouver. You guys lost at the buzzer twice this series. Game 1 and Game 7. Bro, that's actually tragic. I feel bad for Vancouver. DeRozan 22. Steven Adams 20. Patty Mills shot horrible but hit the game winner. Oh my god. Okongwu had 11 and 8. Derek White had 11. RJ struggled from the floor. Ben Simmons struggled. Yeah. Vancouver, come on, man. Man, shout out on a good season. They forced seven games with the 2 seed. Just came up short, but this team is young and talented, so watch out for them in the coming years. For Arizona, their season continues on the round 2 against St. Louis, so great first round series finally come to end. Let's go ahead and preview round 2.
All right, guys. Let's get into the final series of round 1, which is the 1 seed Dallas Stallions taking on the 8 seed Portland Pioneers. And let's just talk about this. Portland, the 8 seed, went on the road and won 95-77. And we can't blame Dame or Boogie because they scored 49 of the 77 points. Yeah, the rest of the team, like, struggled from the floor. Let me just show off these shooting numbers. 2 of 5, 1 of 3, 2 of 5, 2 of 6, 2 of 2, 1 of 6, 0 of 4. I mean, yeah, Dame went 9 of 25 and Boogie went 9 of 14. Dame even shot 1 of 11 from the 3-point line. But they led the way in scoring. Caldwell Pope dropped them off by scoring 23 points. Devin Booker had 14 on 4 of 13 shooting. He shot terrible and they won by 18. Richardson had 12. Kemba had 11. Robert Williams had 10. Jeff Green had 10. Christian Wood had 7. Sandoresky had 6. Like, jeez, bro. How did you, like, that? Let's just move on to game 2. Game 2. Portland again. 71-63. Dame dropped 24 and was by himself. He shot 9 of 20. 4-12 from the 3-point line, though. That was a better improvement. Dame is down 2-0 to an 8 seed. Richardson led the way with 17. Caldwell Pope at 13. Kemba with 10. Book with 9. Jeff Green, Christian Wood. Freaking Korkmaz had 6 points. Like, jeez. I need Dame time. You guys are down 2-0. Game 3. That's what we're talking about. A 92-57 win for Dallas to finally get a win in this series. That third quarter was sheesh, golly. 23-5. Book led the way with 18. He only missed one shot, and he fouled out. Pain. Josh Richardson had 13 points. Kemba Walker had 8. He shot 3 of 12. Jeez, look at all these numbers. Christian Wood, never mind. We'll just move on. I told you, Dame time, 30 points. For him, in this one, he shot better. Bogdanovich had 16. Osman 9, yeah. Yeah. Dallas, you're down 2-1, though. So, you're in better shape than being down 3-0 to an 8 seed. I'll give you that. But let's see if Dallas wins. If we're going to count this one, then. Let's see if Dallas wins 4 straight after being down 0-2. Or Portland can make some magic and shock the 1 seed. Let's see what happens.
Alright guys, game 4 is looking pretty well. Portland, the 8 seed, trying to win this one. Go up 3-1 in the series against the 1 seed out west, but Dallas has the 1-point lead right now. So let's see if Dallas can hold on to this lead and even the series back up at 2. Well, guys, you already know the deal. It's overtime. Going to the last 2 minutes. Well, inside the last 2 minutes. If it's a close game, hop back in. If not, box score time. But, yeah, so... Oh, that was a huge shot by Chetty Osman to send the game to overtime. Kept Dallas from being down 3-1. Let's see if they can take that momentum of tying the game and winning it now. Well, Dallas ended up holding on in overtime and winning by 7. But shout out Portland. Huge game right there. Kemba had 27 and 10. Devin Booker had 21. Christian Wood had 20 and 12. Richardson 17, Caldwell Pope 10. Like, this is one of the highest scoring games we've ever seen. Probably the highest scoring game we've ever seen. Dame time came out 37 points for the Stallions. Bogdanovic had 15. Kleber had 15. Osman had 11, including the tying 3 to send it to overtime. And Zubac had 10 and 8. Melly had 9. Like, really good game. This was really a good game, as you could tell. But now the series will shift to Dallas with the series tied at 2. Alright guys, game 5 in Dallas. The Stallions have a 3-point lead, so you already know we're going to hop into this and see who can win this and take a commanding 3-2 series lead. Well, after losing the first 2 straight games in this series, Portland has lost, after losing the first 2 of this series, Dallas has won 3 straight, and now has a 3-2 series lead after the 86-78 victory at home. It was Dame time. I don't know if you caught on to that, but yeah, it was Dame time. 23 for Dame. Bogdanovic had 18 to help him out. A lot of players scored over 5 points for Dallas. They needed that one. Devin Booker leading the way with 20 points. Kemba had 18. Christian Wood had 12 and 9. Jeff Green had 10 points. I mean, Portland had the scores, well, the pieces. They just didn't score enough to win this one. So Portland will now have to go home and try to force a game 7 on their home court. All right, after they lose the first 2 games of the series, Dallas wins 4 straight and ends Portland season 95-64. Devin Booker leading the way at 21 points. Richardson at 11. Kemba struggled. Yeah, this team kind of struggled at the team to do anything. I'm scared to look at Dallas' box score. I feel like Dame still... If Dame didn't score 40, I'd be surprised. Okay, he dropped 29, though. And then Boogie had 22 and Zubac had 10. Yeah, big team win, especially. Yeah, Boogie and Dame went stupid in this one, man. They went stupid. 51 combined points? Yep, 51. That's crazy. So Dallas is going to move on. We have our first second round matchup set. It's going to be Dallas versus Las Vegas. We will preview that game next episode after we get done with all the game sevens. But we have our first second round matchup. Dallas and Las Vegas will play each other. But, yep. So Dallas, congrats on moving on. Portland, congrats on the great season. You guys have a very young team right here, so the future is going to be bright for you guys.
All right, guys, it's time to preview round two. Let's get into it. First matchup, the 1 seed Dallas Stallions will be taking on the 4 seeded Las Vegas Dealers. As you remember now, Las Vegas clean 4-0 sweep against OKC. And for Dallas, after losing the first two against the 8-seeded Portland Pioneers, they won 4 straight and got going. As you see, the top 2 scorers in the playoffs are in this game. And the top 2 scoring teams are in this series right here. Dallas averaging 88 points so far in the playoffs. And Las Vegas is at 84. And then you got Dame and Kyrie both averaging 28 plus a game. So this has the makings to be a fun series. The season series went Dallas's way 2-0. With Dallas winning the first matchup in Las Vegas 93-90. And got my box score up right here. Kyrie had 21-12 in that one. Drew Holiday had 16. Jay Crowder 15. Capella 14. Willie Cauley-Stein had 11. That helped out. And if you come over here to Dallas, Dame time was active. 31-10 for him in that one. Boogie had 19-7-5. Bogdanovich 8 points. I mean, when it was Dame time that game, as you could tell by the box score right here. The second matchup of the season in Dallas was also won by the Stallions. They won the series 2-0. On February 9th, they won this home matchup by a score of 84-66. Dame time, 20 points in that one. Jeff Green had 15 off the bench. Brandon Clark, 12 points. Bogdanovich, 9. Osman, 9. Like, Boogie was out for this one, and they still won by almost 20. Kyrie had 17 points. Didn't really shoot the ball that well. Jay Crowder had 12. Capella had 12. And Drew Holiday with 10 points, but just not enough to keep up with Dame and the squad. So this has been making to be a good series to me. I think it has potential with both teams. It's going to be a high-scoring series. It's going to be a real high-scoring series. It just depends on who comes out to play more. I don't know, because Dallas struggled against Portland. Yeah, I know they won the series, but they got blown out in the first game by almost 20 points against the 8 seed at home. So this is going to be a fun series. I don't know why. I feel like Las Vegas has more power to them. So I do see the 1 seed Dallas going home, but I do expect this to go 7 games. So get ready for a fun 7-game series, in my opinion. But Kyrie and Las Vegas will head to the conference finals. That's going to be my prediction for this series. Now we will finish it up with the last matchup. Arizona, the 2 seed, will take on this 6 seeded St. Louis Rivermen. St. Louis, the 2nd 6 seed to move on. As you see by the stats right here, oh my god, like, how they're getting outscored in their win. And like, what, they're getting outscored by 3 points a game, and they moved on to round two. DeRozan leading the way. He's the only out of all these leading scorers. Well, yeah. These are the 2 teams with leading scores that don't have 20 plus a game. This is going to be a fun series. Looking at the recap during the season series, Arizona and St. Louis split. St. Louis, or both teams went on the road. St. Louis went in the first matchup 62-61. And this is how far back we go, because it's in December, the beginning of the season, when Arizona had Westbrook on the team leading the way with 16 points. Like, yeah. The only one on that team still, Gordon Hayward had 8 points. Okoji had 9 points. Besides that, that's really it. For St. Louis, they were led by LaMelo having 20 that game. Evan Fournier had 13. Okiki had 6. Zion was hurt, so he missed this matchup. But the next matchup in St. Louis was won by Arizona. on the road. That was in April 13th. 69-66. Zion 15 leading the way for St. Louis. Cole Anthony had 14. LaMelo had 10. Okiki 9. Really good game. For Arizona, Steven Adams led the way with 17 points. DeRozan had 16. Cantor had 11. Okoji had 10. Patty Mills was there. Like, yeah. If this series low-key goes the way that I would think it would go, which the two regular season games were close matchups, I do expect this one to be a close matchup. And I'm still not sleeping on St. Louis, so watch this. St. Louis in 7. That's what I'm picking. I'm taking St. Louis in 7. You heard it here first. We're going to have a 4-6 matchup out west. I don't know about Arizona to me. I mean, DeRozan's going to lead them in scoring this series. He just needs help. If he gets the help he needs, then they have a shot. But I think St. Louis's young core is going to come out the ball. I mean, Zion's going to be Zion. I expect LaMelo to have a big series. I just expect that to happen. I expect a huge series out of LaMelo. So I'm going to take St. Louis in 7. And now with that being said, that's going to end this video. I'm going to go ahead and just pause it right here to show you guys how I did out west, like I did in the last one. I only went 1-3 out east, so in my predictions for the first round, let's see how I did in the west. So yeah, hope you guys did enjoy this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it being split up in two parts. It wasn't supposed to be like that, but it happened to happen. So getting ready to get into round 2. Should be a fun one. I hope you guys are excited. Make sure you guys like, comment, share, subscribe, turn on post notifications so you don't miss an upload. And yeah, that's all I got for this one. I hope you guys did enjoy the first round. Hope you guys are excited for round 2. I am very excited. I can't wait to see what happens. We're getting closer and closer to crowning our first ever champion. So hope you guys are excited for that. So yeah, with that being said, I'll catch you guys on the next one. When they play both sides, too low in my life, so I gotta stay high. Yeah, I gotta stay high.